Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Usually I make most of my videos on Apple products and I don't really review Android stuff that much. But since it's the start of a new year, just like last year, I figured I'd take a look at what the latest Android budget offering was. This is the Realme XT. I've been using it alongside my iPhone for around 2 weeks now. This phone is quite an eye-catcher. It's been one full year since I last reviewed an Android phone, and well, here I am back again to see what it's like. With the starting price at 16,000 rupees and the amount of features that it offers, this phone is the budget phone to beat. It's really impressive how companies like Realme are beginning to offer so much for so less. It all comes at a little cost though, which I'll talk about later. But first, let's talk about this color, shall we? This blue color is really something else. Light shines, warps, flows, and bends through the color like I've never seen anything like this before. It's crazy. The bottom of the phone is standard issue. One speaker, a USB-C port, a microphone, and 3.5mm jack. The phone has got a narrow and slim profile and is quite easy to hold. I really like the accented orange power button. On the left of the phone, you have your volume rocker and your SIM card and microSD card tray. The buttons are, well, they're okay. They're made out of plastic and they have a decent bit of travel, but they don't feel the best, but they do the job. One of my favorite features of this phone is how fast this thing charges. Like, holy crap, I can just take the cable out of my MacBook and plug it into my phone, and within a few minutes, well, I've got 100% charge. I plug it into the same charger as my MacBook Pro, and I've not had any issues. It works just as fast as the normal charger. The fact that it's USB-C makes it all the better. It's easy to just unplug from my MacBook and back into the phone. Previously, I really disliked the fingerprint scanners under the display for how slow they were, but this is a big improvement. It's nice and fast. Speaking of the display, it's got a massive 6.43-inch display with a resolution of 2340 into 1080. The display is an OLED display and it gets nice and bright outdoors with inky blacks and super vivid colors. It's a nice and crisp panel, but I've had a few issues with this display, and I'm not sure where it lies, but I'll talk about it later. I don't use Android's gesture systems because it's not as smooth and fluid as the iPhone's. It feels kind of broken and chunky. I feel like the perfect way to operate Android is with those buttons. Another one of my favorite features is the support for Dolby Atmos. It makes the audio coming out of this phone so much better. There's a lot of improvement. As far as the system UI goes, there's a lot of improvement since last year's ColorOS. Though I'd like to see something a little closer to stock Android, it seems like we might get that this year with ColorOS 7. Nonetheless, the UI is still a good experience. One of the things I have the biggest problems with is all these preloaded apps. Just look at them, there's so many. There's a lot of system ads and another app store, which I really don't need. Enough of all that though, let's get to what you were waiting for, the camera review. This phone's got a monster quad camera setup that seems like it trumps the competition. And that huge camera bump at the top is the ultrawide, in the middle, the main 16MP sensor, the depth sensor, and then the macro lens. But wait, there's a little more to photography than just the number of cameras. Let me explain. I have zero complaints on the front-facing 16MP camera. Just don't use the beauty mode and everything will look awesome. The main highlight here is the ultra 64MP mode. It's not a 64MP sensor, but it uses a 4-in-1 pixel binning technology to get this super beautiful and crisp image to life. They've done a great job on this mode and the results are almost always stunning and crisp. Kinda wish that this was the default. There's a lot of different modes to select from when you're using the camera app. Up at the top, you can choose whether you want to use the ultrawide or turn on this mode called Chroma Boost. I'm not sure what it does, but it seems to add a little bit of saturation kick to the photos. It was all good till here, till everything kind of fell apart. Zooming in with the main lens yields a better result than the macro lens itself, which is kind of shocking. The main lens captures much sharper and much better looking macro photos than the macro lens itself. And the macro lens seems to struggle in every sort of lighting condition. Another thing that annoyed me was poor low light performance. You see, this here is an AI night mode shot, but the one that you see here now is a manual shot. Look at the difference. It's like this in every single night mode photo. And it's not that this phone is bad in low light. I mean, you can see right here that these photos are enough to rival even the iPhone 11 Pro. But they're shot in full manual, and I don't think that it should be that way. I'm really happy with the addition of the ultrawide lens on this phone. It just brings an entirely new perspective to every single photo that you take. That wider field of view brings a lot more into the frame, but at a little bit of a cost. You see, as soon as the light gets a little challenging, well, it completely loses it. But other than that, I can't complain much more. The fact that it's there is a big deal, and I really enjoyed shooting with the ultrawide. Going back to my iPhone, well, I kind of miss it. I wish it was there too. One of the things that you should completely avoid shooting on this phone, though, is the 960fps slow motion. Please choose either 120 or 240. Video on this phone isn't too bad. Dynamic range is sort of off and there's a lot of noise even in daylight, but the 4K mode makes up for it. Like I said before, the display is beautiful. It's nice and vivid and gets nice and bright as well, but one of the problems that I've had is with YouTube on HDR. You see, this phone completely blows out the highlights in HDR. I was wondering why it was doing that because it seemed like it could retain the details, but then I checked Netflix and it said it's not capable of HDR. Of course, I don't expect HDR at this price point, but if it doesn't support it, it shouldn't play it. I hope that's fixed soon. Last but not least, the performance of this phone. Most of you buying this phone are probably buying it so that you can play PUBG. Worry not, this phone plays it just fine and maintains good battery life while doing so. It doesn't play HD well for too long, so I usually leave it in balanced. Screen recording and playing works just fine. Although I've had some network connectivity issues with this game, it's kind of frustrating, but it's not the end of the world. Overall, this is a really great phone. If you aren't willing to spend a ridiculous amount of money on your next phone, this is probably one of your best options. It's got everything that you'd need in a phone. My only disappointment is that it's not all that it's shown off to be. Reviewing this phone was kind of confusing for me. It was really hard to review, but overall, I'd still recommend it for you to buy. It's a great phone for what its price is. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked this video, hit the like button and share it with your friends, and hit subscribe to stay tuned for more awesome content coming soon. Once again, thank you, and I'll see you guys in the next one.